To present tonight's first Crystal Award for Advocacy, Oscar, Emmy, and double Tony Award-winning producer and star of The Woman King, the iconic Viola Davis.
Thank you. There is nothing like a standing ovation after just rolling out of bed and throwing on this suit. So I'm here to present the Crystal Award for Advocacy to Gina Prince-Bythewood. You know what? Art is supposed to move you. It's supposed to make you tremble. It's supposed to make you feel less alone. It's supposed to make you recognize something within yourself that is both joyful, putrid, shameful, secret. And I say all of that to say that oftentimes Black women aren't included in that. That narrative that we can all even connect to in this room, all being women, sometimes we're not even a part of that. I say that because when we were given the script of The Woman King, which is epic in scope, it is a period piece. It's epic not just in terms of the physical landscape of the kingdom of Dahomey. It's epic in the sense of the history of the Agogia, the Izogi, Naniska, Nawi, Ode, all of these characters that required complexity. I think I've literally walked through my entire career, and the common conversation on the set is, listen, I'm telling you, this is just not who I am. You know, you're writing this in the script, but I could tell you how to make it deeper. I'm not just a strong Black woman. I could be vulnerable, I could be sensitive. I could be morally questionable. I'm not always nurturing. Gina came to the office of Juvie and we interviewed her to be the director, the leader of this piece. And it was, sorry Gina, but it's the only time that I literally saw a director cry. She wept. And I knew that in the weeping, what she was doing was that she would be a good steward over this film. That she would make sure that the story of the Agogi, of Naniska and Nawi and Izogi and Amenza and Ode and all of the beautiful, richly drawn characters would be received and given to you as human beings. Fully realized that you could sit with us for 2 hours and 6 minutes. And the reason why I knew that is because her heart was moved. I know that you know that oftentimes as an artist, it's not just in the results, it's in the process. It's in the being on these sets and getting what you need to be better, to be more open, to have someone who has your back, who sees you, where you're not explaining your hair, your skin, your makeup, the fact that the microaggressions of someone walking on a set and constantly insulting you. And let me tell you something, as a dark-skinned Black woman, the insults sometimes are so underhanded that you don't even notice. the word usage, the being ignored, the being invisible, the being the third girl on the left. This film required a freaking warrior. And that's what we had in Gina Prince-Bythewood, a warrior, an artistic champion. Because at the end of the day, I know art is not rocket science, but it's an art form. And it's an art form in a world where we are increasingly feeling alone and isolated and not connected. And here you have Gina Prince-Bythewood on a set for 5 months, 3 months preparing for this bad boy. 5 hours of training a day for 3 months, 5 months of shooting on the hot, sweltering sets in different various parts of South Africa with lions, tigers, and bears. You have no idea. Lions, tigers, and bears, y'all. She rode this damn horse of a movie until it couldn't be ridden anymore. And now it is literally of my 33-year career, Gina, it is the work that I'm most proud of. Because it's ours. And you had the scope, the vision, the talent, the bravery to bring it to fruition. So what I will say to you is this. Very, very, very simple. It's sort of grand, but it's appropriate. Oh, Captain, my Captain. Our fearful trip is done. The ship has weathered every rack. The prize we sought is won. Gina, it is my honor to present to you 2023 Crystal Award for Advocacy for Women. For all women, for black women, for dark-skinned black women who have so long been told that we are not women, that we are not feminine, that we are not vulnerable, that we do not matter, that I'm presenting you this award with the passion in knowing, the thankfulness in knowing, that you made us be seen.
I'm actually not giving a speech, so we're gonna all sit here. So I'm a little like, oh fuck, what am I?
Moderating our first panel conversation of the evening is senior entertainment writer for Variety, Angelique Jackson, joined by the Woman King cast members, Thuso, Mbedu, Lashana Lynch, and Viola Davis.
Gina, I'm not gonna lie, you could moderate this if you want to. You are really the captain of all things. So do you wanna just I'll give you these? I'm just kidding. I will start this out though. There's a special message that I was asked to share from Women in Film President Emeritus Kathy Schulman, who you all know very well, who produced The Woman King alongside Viola and Julius Tenen. She's shooting in Atlanta and she couldn't be here tonight, but she wanted to send you some special words. She says, "Thank you, Gina, for giving every one of us who knows you and so many other women and girls across the globe the courage to embrace our inner warrior. Congratulations on your award tonight. You deserve all the love and praise in the world." Well, to continue that praise a bit, you have really made a hallmark of your career, including women both in front of and behind the camera, so much so on this film that it qualified for that reframe stamp of gender balanced production. Why has that been so important to you, and how have you made it happen despite, you know, potential pushback at any turn?
Foremost, I apologize for cursing. For anyone to speak about you in that way, I need to play that on loop anytime I'm not feeling like a warrior. So thank you so much. I know how I was coming up and trying to get into the rooms, coming out of film school and not being allowed in the rooms. And it wasn't for lack of talent, it was just lack of opportunity. So for me, it's never a PC thing. The women, the people of color that I surround myself with, on my crew, they make me better. They're so talented. We have three in the audience now, our DP, Polly Morgan. Our writer, Dana Stevens. And our editor, Terilyn Shropshire. But again, these women, it was important for me to look past the resume. Nobody had done a film at this size before, but their passion, their desire to be a part of it, their desire to be great, it meant everything. And to be then in production meetings and any type of meeting, and you look around the table and suddenly you're not the only, but you're part of a group, to see what that does for people who are used to not being heard, not being respected. When you are respected, when you are heard, when your voice matters, it brings out the best in you, and that's what I got from my crew.
Thuso and Lashana, I want to continue what the incredible Ms. Viola Davis said in that speech. You know, that idea of Gina as the captain of this team, the captain of this film, what did it do for your performances to have this woman at the helm and also to be, you know, a part of the team with you?
Okay, so for me, in terms of Gina being the captain, I need to highlight the fact that normally, in my experience, when you first audition, it's just you and the casting director. But in this audition, Gina was there from the jump. You know, and then having gotten the role and me putting myself in, like, you know, just like Muay Thai classes so that I can prepare for training, and Gina coming to train with me. Do you get me? It's like she was always going the extra step. You know, I was there because sometimes I take like the bus to go to training, but then she'd drive me home. That's our captain, you know, and then, yeah, clap for that. And then again, now when we're in pre-production training and she's training with us, you know, struggling with us. She's got other things to do, but she was always there, you know, championing us, but also creating a space where your voice matters, what you say, your thoughts, your opinion on set matters. It wasn't a dictatorship, it was a give and take. It was a very collaborative process where you felt safe enough to say, "I do not agree with that." That's the captain who sailed the ship.
You're exactly right. You're just meeting Gina's energy. you already have invited a visceral experience on set, which, like Viola said, as a black, dark-skinned woman, you have to inhale and exhale when stepping on a set, because you know that there's certain conversations that haven't been had for you on your behalf. Now, with Gina, she'd already seen my work and seen me speak and had decided that there's something else that I can do, something that I can see in myself, which is usually your parents, your family, your best friends. When there is a black woman director who you have admired since her first film, Love and Basketball. There's already a bow on that. She could have just finished with that and we would have been cool. But she kept going and she saw me before I saw myself for Azogi. And not only being with us in training, not only breathing life into these characters, being available at 10 p.m. to have a conversation, on Sundays to have a conversation, meeting up to discuss character, to discuss your craft, to discuss you. How's your family doing? How are you? How's your heart? How's your spirit? How are you connecting with this person? And in seeing the humanity in yourself more, you are able to add more humanity to this black woman you are representing on the screen. And that's through her eyes and her mind and her glory. So I thank you for that, truly.
And Viola, I want to expand on something else that you said, because something that stands out in this movie is that it allows these women, these strong women, these warrior women, to also be soft, to also show that vulnerability. You know, tell me a little bit more about how important it is for the industry to allow women, and especially black women, to show that vulnerability.
Because culturally, we've always been given the stigma that we are not vulnerable, that we are not feminine, that we are not soft, that we are not messy, that it's a usual message of you're strong to the point of, I literally had a character once that I auditioned for, and I remember my agent saying, Viola, in the background, they say, she's strong, no vulnerability whatsoever, like none. I'm like, well, how do I play that? But I feel like that's been completely acceptable for black women, for us to be overly nurturing, for us to always have the answers. It is really important for us to be introduced to the world as human beings and as women. It is so vital that literally, I mean, you, Lashana and Thuso could tell you just how, as actors, how it affected our work, but as women, how it affects us. So often people don't feel like we need help, that they don't need to have our backs, that we always sort of have the answers. And let me tell you something, the worst is that we're not cute. Now, you know how I feel. Well, if you don't know how I'm not too big on cute. But there is a value associated with women, with beauty. And we have never been a part of that as black women, especially dark-skinned women. The nose is too wide, the lips are too big, and literally it is a message that's been given down in generations. We have to stop it. The stigma kills us, first of all, just in society in general, but it especially kills us in art. I mean, you look at films, you don't know who the hell we are half the time. We come in service. And it's important, if we literally are committed to diversity and inclusion, then that's the one thing that we need to be committed to break all of the stereotypes and stigma attached to being black. Because it is the job of the artist to create human beings. So I'm telling you, as a human being, a lot of the images that you see on, it's just not who I am. So we have to have the bravery and the strength to literally be about that. Does that make sense?
Well, I have to thank you all for this conversation, but Gina, I also have to thank you for being about that. From your first film, Love and Basketball, through this film, The Woman King. And I want to just give you one more moment to just celebrate and to say what it means to have received this award tonight.
It's like starting from when I was in film school, coming up in the TV and in the films that I did, this was an event that was always over there, something that I looked for and was waiting for that invite. And this is my first invitation. and to be honored with this group of women, these are all women that I just have so much respect for. And it's a beautiful thing to be here, but also it means everything that these three amazing, amazing humans are here to celebrate this with me. So thank you.
Also, one last woman I have to mention is Nicole Brown. MVP, Stuart, Nicole.
If it wasn't for that woman, this movie would not have gotten made. For anybody who doesn't know out here in the audience, president of TriStar Pictures, thank you all so much, and please enjoy the rest of the evening.
Thank you, everybody.